Okay, yeah. Brilliant.
Just come next to me. That's brilliant. So I'm here with Liam Tancock. You're the world's fastest backstroke swimmer, is that correct?
Yeah, that's a world record owner, yeah.
Yeah, for 50 metres.
World record owner.
How fast can you swim a 50 metre backstroke?
So the world record stands at the moment at 24.04 seconds.
Yeah.
And that's a long course, Olympic size pool.
Right, right. Do you think you'd be able to go even quicker than that by the time of the next Olympics?
The 50 isn't actually in the Olympics, it's not an Olympic event, right, but yeah. I've been working hard on the 100 to improve my times on that, so hopefully I'll, you know, do some best times and see how it goes, really.
Yeah, are you excited about the 2012 Olympics?
I can't wait. Ever since it got announced, it was one of those things that, you know, inspires me, and yeah, with, 2 years to go now, it's, you know, it's pretty exciting.
Yeah, yeah. So what do you do to train? I know it's not something of a typical day, but... You know, what have you been doing this week, for example, to work on your 100?
For example, say on a Monday, a usual Monday would be I'd get up, I'd do in the pool for 2.5 hour session.
Yeah.
With obviously stretching before and after. Then down to the gym where I'd be in the, you know, weights room for about 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And I'll be back to my house, have some food, have some lunch.
Right.
Recovery.
Yeah.
And then, you know, probably about 2 or 3 hours later, I'll be back down the pool and swim for another 2.5 hours, stretch, and I'm back home, have some food, and then off to bed.
So is it important what you eat? Is there a special diet that you have to follow?
To an extent, yeah. I think it's very important what you eat. I've just grown up with doing the right thing, I guess, now, so it's the norm for me.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think you've got to eat the right things, but at the right times. Obviously, you can't eat too close to training, but you can't. And the window to get the optimum amount of nutrients into your body as soon as swimming's finished.
Yeah.
So, it's more about the key timings of when you eat to what you eat.
And you've always been a pretty sporty guy. You started off as a rugby player, or you did competitive rugby when you were a teenager.
I love sport. I love sport. I've always loved sport. And yeah, I used to play rugby. I used to do all sports, to be honest, but I played rugby for Exeter and really enjoyed that. Obviously swam for Exeter and it came to a time where I needed to decide what was gonna, you know, be my main focus, and I chose swimming and never looked back.
Yeah, yeah. Why was it just swimming? Just was that the best sport, the one you enjoyed the most, or?
I really don't know. My brother used to do swimming. I had some great friends in swimming, I had some great friends in rugby. But yeah, it was something I loved to do. It was more often than rugby. I used to train rugby only a few times a week, whereas swimming, you know, it can be, well, I'm up to 10 times a week now, so and I just loved it. To be honest, I just love sport, and I think that's always been the focus.
You're an Exeter City fan, aren't you?
Yeah, Exeter City fan, Exeter Chiefs fan, so the football and rugby are doing well at the moment, and proud supporter of them both.
So, do you think we're going to get many medals in 2012? Any predictions of, you know, swimmers we should look out for, apart from yourself?
I think while everyone's out of Becky Adamson, she did a great job at the last Olympics. She's picking up 2 golds, and, you know, that's not been done for 100 years with British swimming, so that's pretty fantastic. But anything can happen. It's a home Olympics. It's inspired so many people, not just us, but at junior levels and kids in school. So I think it's really an important time, and you know, if the fans are behind us, which I'm sure they will be, you know, not just swimming, but a lot of different sports, you know, great things can happen.
Yeah, yeah. Just briefly, the step up from 50 metres to 100 metres, I mean, everyone looks pretty good at a 50 metre swimmer, is it? Isn't that immense? Is it a big, I mean, obviously twice the distance, but does it require a lot more from you? I mean, the technical skill in the turn, is that what you're practicing now?
Yeah, obviously in a 50 there's no turn, and obviously in 100 there will be.
Yeah.
You're a turn and you've got to come back for the second half of the race at the 50 metres. So obviously that's a key element and what I've definitely been working on. But yeah, it's a slightly different focus. Obviously a 50 is an all-out sprint, and to be honest, a 100 pretty much is an all-out sprint.
Yeah.
You just got to be clever with the way you do it. Get the right race tactics and the training tactics to. You know, to get out fast, strong, with your easy speed, and actually hold it and come back strong as well. It's all about being consistent, consistently fast, and that's the key, really.
Do you remain competitive, I presume, in Americans,
Australians, there's a Spanish guy, there's some Russians.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? There's some really good competition out there at the moment, and obviously I've been testing myself against them for a number of years, but I will be in the next couple of years, and ultimately at London 2012.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you, Lynn.
Brilliant.
Thanks for your time.
Cheers. There you are.
Thanks. Brilliant. exactly 5 minutes. It's excellent.